driving because most of my viewers probably do drive. And driving is a fantastic way to explore our use of energy and our awareness of balance and our awareness of our center of gravity. Because the car is an extension of your body, it's an extension of your being when you're driving. And you certainly see people's personality or aspects of their personality come out in the way that people drive. If you want to reduce your gas consumption, it's a good idea to avoid too much acceleration and too much braking, because every time you accelerate and every time you brake, you're using more gas than you need to. You may feel that driving this way is boring, but it's not actually, because when you practice being that present, that you're aware of how much energy you're using at any given moment, that presence in itself can be very enjoyable. And of course, it also makes you a much safer driver and a much more comfortable driver to be a passenger with. Well, this is an old car, and everyone likes to drive a brand new car. Very smooth, very comfortable, very luxurious. Old cars, as they begin to build up wear and tear, they don't feel so smooth. But I've found that driving an old car as if it was a brand new car is quite a good idea. And driving it as if you had a couple of dozen eggs on the back seat, or in this case 30 eggs, on the back seat as you drive is a great idea, because you really have to pay attention to how you accelerate and how you brake if you want to keep those eggs intact. We have great eggs around here. The chickens run around freely, and the eggs are really very different from what you get in the supermarket. And I don't want to break them. So the thing about being in a car is that whether you're a driver or a passenger, you can practice being aware of your center of gravity and how it moves. When you pay attention to these things, you start to notice things that you wouldn't otherwise notice. For example, when you're a passenger, you tend to move around much more than when you're a driver, because the driver, having their hands on the wheel, are stabilized. Whereas the passenger, unless they hang on to the loop on the above the passenger door, they are being thrown around. And the driver is able to anticipate the movements of the car because of being in control of the car, whereas the passenger doesn't have that connection with the way the car is moving. What that means is, if you connect with all of the muscles that surround your waist, your center, as a passenger, you can start to get a little bit of exercise when you're riding in a car with someone. A friend of mine told me that when he traveled around the world, he lost weight going as a passenger on four-wheel drive vehicles across rough terrain, because of the amount of movement, active involvement of the waist. He found that it was burning fat off of his belly, being a passenger in a Jeep. So that's an interesting observation. What I've found is that if you connect consciously with muscles, they start to work more. So the more you actually connect with your own anatomy, the more exercise you get in the course of ordinary, mundane activities.